गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे डिस्कस अबाउट द न्यू चैप्टर, सिक्स चैप्टर, इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन. सो फर्स्ट, व्हाट इज मेंट बाय इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन? सो इट इज़ द प्रोसेस इन विच एन EMF इज इंड्यूस इन द क्वाइल ड्यू टू द चेंज इन मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स लिंक्ड विद दैट क्वाइल इज कॉल्ड व्हाट? इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन. So Faraday's, we can prove the some experiment, then we can find out the some laws. So that laws is called what? Faraday's laws. So first, one by one, Faraday's experiment. First experiment, coil and magnet experiment. So this is a coil and this is the bar magnet. So this coil is connected to the galvanometer. So consider a coil of few turns of conducting material insulated from one another and it is connected to a sensitive galvanometer. So in this experiment, what happens here? So one by one, step by step. So first step, when a north pole of the bar magnet is moved towards the coil, the galvanometer shows deflection. That means it indicates that the current is induced in the coil, isn't it? Suppose when the bar magnet is brought to rest or it is held in stationary, the bar magnet is held in stationary, so there is no deflection in the galvanometer, isn't it? Suppose when the north pole of the bar magnet is moved away from the coil, again the galvanometer shows deflection but in opposite direction. That means what? It indicates that current is induced in the conductor, isn't it? So when a bar of north pole of the bar magnet is moved towards the coil, ee bar magnet anna towards the coil atta tagomandaga galvanometer en torusutte, deflection torusutte, either it may be clockwise or anti clockwise in direction. Andre idra artha eno? Current illi ಇಂಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಯಿತು ಅಂತಲೇ ಅರ್ಥ. ಸಪೋಸ್ ಬಾರ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟ್ ನಾನು ರೆಸ್ಟಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಬಿಡ್ತೀನಿ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೆಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಸ್ಟೇಷ್ನರಿ. ಸೊ ರೆಸ್ಟಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಟಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ದೆರ್ ಈಸ್ ನೋ ಡಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಗೆಲ್ನೋಮೀಟರ್. ಸೊ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಗೆಲ್ನೋಮೀಟ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ತೋರಿಸೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಅದೇ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಸರ್ತಿ ಬಾರ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟನ್ನು ಈ ಕಾಯಿಲ್ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ಹಾದು ಹೊರಗಡೆ ತೆಗೆದ್ರೆ ಅಗೇನ್ ಗೆಲ್ನೋಮೀಟ್ರ್ ಏನು ತೋರಿಸುತ್ತೆ? ಡಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ತೋರಿಸುತ್ತೆ. ಇದರ ಅರ್ಥ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಕಾಯಿಲಲ್ಲಿ ಕರೆಂಟು ಇಂಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಯಿತು ಅಂತ ಅರ್ಥ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಯಿಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರಿಮೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಕಾಯಿಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟ್, ಇಸ್ಂಟ್ ಇಟ್? ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಯಿಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರಿಮೆಂಟ್. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರಿಮೆಂಟ್, ಕಾಯಿಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಾಯಿಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರಿಮೆಂಟ್. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರಿಮೆಂಟ್, coil and coil experiment. So coil and coil experiment. So coil C1, so this is coil C2, so second experiment is coil and coil experiment. So consider a coil C1 of few turns of conducting material insulated from one another, it is connected to the galvanometer. So C2 coil is connected to the battery, is as shown in the diagram, isn't it? So C1 coil is fixed. So when C2 coil is moved towards the coil C1, the galvanometer shows deflection. That means what? It indicates that current is induced in the coil C1. Similarly, when C2 coil is moved away from the coil C1, again the galvanometer shows deflection but in opposite in direction. That means what? Again it indicates that current is induced in the coil C1. Similarly, C2 coil is fixed when C1 coil is moved towards or away from the coil C2. Again the same effects will be observed. So this is coil and coil experiment. Then finally, what is meant by electromagnetic induction means it is the process in which an EMF is induced in the coil due to the changing magnetic flux linked with that coil. So it is called what? Electromagnetic induction. So based on these experiment, Faraday, we can find out the some laws. So Faraday first law and second law. ಈ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರಿಮೆಂಟ್ಗಳ ಆಧಾರದ ಮೇಲೆ ಫ್ಯಾರಡೇ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಎರಡು ಲಾಸನ್ನು ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲಾ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಲಾ. ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾದರೆ ಫ್ಯಾರಡೇ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲಾ ಏನು ಹೇಳುತ್ತೆ? ಫ್ಯಾರಡೇ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲಾ. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ದ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫ್ಲಕ್ಸ್ ಲಿಂಕ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ EMF ಈಸ್ ಇಂಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯೂಟ್ and this EMF exists as long as change takes place, that is the first law. Second law, Faraday second law. So the magnitude of the induced EMF is directly proportional to the rate of change of magnetic flux linked with the coil. So d phi by dt, E is proportional to d phi by dt, then E is equal to minus k into d phi by dt, where k is constant, where negative sign it indicates that the direction of the induced EMF. therefore E is equal to d phi by dt. So this is the Faraday second law. So once again, the statement of the Faraday's first statement, first law. So whenever the magnetic flux linked with the coil, whenever the magnetic flux linked with the circuit and EMF is induced in the circuit, and this EMF exists as long as change takes place. Second law, the magnitude of the induced EMF is directly proportional to the change of rate, the rate of change of magnetic flux linked with that coil. So that is the statement of the Faraday second law. So next one, eddy current. So already you know about current, but here eddy current, very important for 3 marks. So first, what is meant by eddy current? The current is induced in the conductor when it is subjected to varying magnetic field. So that is called eddy current. So where it can be applicable for the eddy current? For example, one by one applications, speedometer. ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ನಾವು ವೆಹಿಕಲ್ಸ್ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ಕಾರುಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಈ ಸ್ಪೀಡೋಮೀಟ್ರನ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ನೋಡಿರಿ, ನೀವು ಎಕ್ಸಲೇಟ್ರನ್ನ ಒದ್ದಂಗೆಲ್ಲ ಏನಾಗ್ತೈತೆ, ಕಾರು ಅಥವಾ ಬೈಕು ಸ್ಪೀಡಾಗಿ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ರೈಸ್ ಆದಂಗೆಲ್ಲ. ಅಂದರೆ ಅದರ ಅರ್ಥ ಏನು? ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಡಿ ಕರೆಂಟ್. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಲ್ಲ? ಸೊ ಎಡಿ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಅಂದರೆ ದ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಂಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟರ್ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ವೇರಿಂಗ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಡಿ ಕರೆಂಟ್. ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಬಲ್ ಅಂದರೆ, ಸೊ ಸ್ಪೀಡೋಮೀಟರ್, second one energy meter, third one induction motor, fourth one electromagnetic damping, fifth one induction furnace, and sixth one is magnetic brakes. So these are the applications of the eddy current, very important for your examination 3 marks. So speedometer, energy meter, induction motor, electromagnetic damping, induction furnace and magnetic brakes. So once again, what is meant by eddy current? The current is induced in the conductor when it is subjected to varying magnetic field. So applications: speedometer, energy meter, induction motor, electromagnetic damping, induction furnace and magnetic brakes. Self induction. So self induction. So self induction ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಮುಂಚೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಈ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ಅರ್ಥ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಇಂಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಅನ್ನು ಡಿಫೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ. ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಓನ್ ಅಂತ ಅರ್ಥ. ಸೊ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಎ ಕಾಯಿಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಎ ಬ್ಯಾಟ್ರಿ ವಿತ್ ಎ ಟ್ಯಾಪ್ ಕೀ ಕೆ ಈಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಶೋನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್. ಇನಿಷಿಯಲಿ ದ ಟ್ಯಾಪ್ ಕೀ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಪ್ರೆಸ್ಡ್, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಓಪನ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯೂಟ್, ಇಸ್ಂಟ್ ಇಟ್? ಇನಿಷಿಯಲಿ ಟ್ಯಾಪ್ ಕೀ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಪ್ರೆಸ್ಡ್, ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್? No electric current is flows through the coil. So current is flow agila andre there is no magnetic flux linked with that coil. So that is step 1. Once again, this is a coil. Consider a coil is connected through a battery with a tap key K. Initially tap key is not pressed. That means what? No electric current is flows through the coil. So there is no magnetic flux linked with that coil. Suppose when a tap key is pressed, the current in the circuit begins to grow from 0 to maximum value. 0 to maximum value. So now tap key enna press madidaga enaythu, it is a closed circuit, then automatically current enaythu flow aythu. So the current in the circuit begins to grow from 0 to maximum value. As the current is increases, then magnetic flux linked with the coil is also increases, isn't it? As the current is increases, magnetic flux linked with the coil is also increases. So when the current reaches a maximum saturation value, the magnetic flux remains constant, isn't it? Third step. So when the tap key is released, so the current begins to decay from maximum to zero value. So magnetic flux is decreases, the current is also decreases, but current does not becomes zero, but it takes some time, isn't it? So agadre en gottaaytu illi nimge? ಸೊ ಟ್ಯಾಪ್ ಕೀಯನ್ನು ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ, ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಏನಾಯಿತು? ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಯಿತು. ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫ್ಲಕ್ಸ್ ಕೂಡ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಯಿತು. ದೆನ್ ಟ್ಯಾಪ್ ಕೀಯನ್ನು ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ, ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಆಯಿತು. ದೆನ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫ್ಲಕ್ಸ್ ಏನಾಯಿತು? ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಆಯಿತು. ಹಾಗಾದರೆ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೆಂಟ್ ಬೈ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಇಂಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಫಿನಾಮಿನನ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆನ್ ಇ ಎಮ್ ಎಫ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಂಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕಾಯಿಲ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ದ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಇಟ್. So that is called what? Self induction. So self means it is its own antartha. So once again, it is the phenomenon in which an EMF is induced in the coil due to the change of current in it. So that is called what? Self induction. So next one, coefficient of self induction. Coefficient of self induction. So already heldi nanu magnetic flux is increases, then current is also increases, isn't it? So phi is proportional to I, then phi is equal to, you can remove the proportionality, L I. So this is equation number 1, where L is called what? Coefficient of self induction. So an EMF is induced in the coil, then automatically magnetic flux linked with the coil is also increases. So from laws of electromagnetic induction, so we can write E is equal to minus d phi by